I enlisted in the Navy because I always wanted to be a sailor. And I failed the test for the Naval Academy, and I went home, told my parents I'm going to enlist. My mother says, no, you got to go to college. I says, nope, I got to enlist. My dad said, don't argue with him, Sophie. They signed the papers, and away I went.
An apron in hand, where he sat in full glee, a few sons of harmony sent a petition.
There's an interesting story behind the tune that we know as the Star Spangled Banner. You know, the original tune was for a tavern song. It was called the Anacreontic Song. It was the song of the Anacreontic Society in London, England.
That he their inspiring patron would be, when this answer arrived from the jolly old Grecian.
It was dedicated to Anacreon, who was a Greek poet of the 6th century BC. The tune dates from the 1760s by John Stafford Smith, who was a member of this Anacreontic Society. And it would have been very familiar to everyone in the English-speaking world, and at the time that Francis Scott Key wrote his words, he would have known this song as one that was shared over a good glass of port in the tavern. And it was very commonplace for tavern songs of this type to be used for popular songs with new words.
Honored guests, comrades, sisters, families, and friends, the members of Post 7632, veterans of foreign war of the United States, and Post 553 of the American Legion, and all other veterans are assembled here to remember comrades who are being held as prisoners of war or missing in action. We must not forget the sacrifices these comrades are still making and the suffering they are still enduring for us in our way of life. They must remain alive in our minds and hearts until we know they have returned home to their loved ones and have been called to the bosom of our Heavenly Father. We must continue to give moral support to their families who continue to suffer along with them. Uncover.
At this time, let us rededicate ourselves to the flag of our country by reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. If you could please stand. The Table of Honor, the symbolism of the Table of Honor. We are able to gather here because so many of our comrades in arms have given the ultimate sacrifice in the name of freedom. In violent arenas of land, sea, and sky, far from homes and families they fought so valiantly for. These brothers and sisters gave their lives or their liberty so that we as a people might remain free. If you will direct your attention to the table in front of me, you will notice it is a place, a table of honor. You will also notice it is set for one. The professionalism of arms is filled with symbolism, and this table is our way of symbolizing the fact that members are still missing from our midst. Most people call them POWs or MIAs. Some others have passed by either by arms or otherwise. We call them comrades. They are unable to be here today with us, so we remember them. The table is set for one. It's small. It symbolizes the frailty of one prisoner alone against his or her oppressors. The tablecloth is white. It symbolizes the purity of their intentions to respond to their country's call to arms. The hat symbolizes our brotherhood or our fraternity. The single rose reminds us of the families and loved ones, our comrades in arms, who kept the faith awaiting their return. Please remember. The red ribbon is to remind us and all Americans that we must stand fast in our unyielding demand for a full and proper account of our missing comrades. Remember. A slice of lemon is on the bread table to remind us of their bitter faith. There is also salt upon the bread plate to symbolize the tears of the families as they wait. Remember, the candle is a symbol of light. Let us always be able to see where we are going and where we as a fraternity has been. Never forget those who have come before us or for those who will follow us. The glass is inverted. They cannot toast with us today. The chair is empty. They are not here. We remember. Remember all of us who served with them, who called them comrades, who depended upon them for their might and their aid, relied upon them, for surely they will remember us.
Before you is the flag of the United States, the flag of our country, for which our imprisoned and missing comrades are still suffering and dying. Look closely upon this beautiful symbol and listen to the words of our officers as they present their symbolic tributes. Junior Vice Commander.
The flag of the United States reflects our prison and missing comrades. The red stripes reflect their courage and willingness to sacrifice, even their lives if necessary. The red of our country's flag has been made redder by their heroism. Therefore, we place these red flowers to symbolize their courage and their gallantry.
Senior Vice Commander.
The white stripes symbolize a purity of purpose that our comrades have in serving under this beautiful flag. The white becomes more stainlessly pure by the motives which impel them. We place these white flowers as a reminder of the unselfish devotion to duty.
Officer of the day.
The blue of our flag symbolizes truth and fidelity and represents the desire of our missing comrades for peace and happiness throughout the world. Therefore, we place these blue flowers to symbolize the great love that our comrades have for our flag and our country.
Chaplain.
As our flag symbolizes undying love for our country, this evergreen tribute, whose color bespeaks life everlasting, symbolizes our undying love for our imprisoned and missing comrades.
As the flag of the United States symbolizes victory over oppression for the living, so this laurel wreath symbolizes victory over death for those who have made the supreme sacrifice. Therefore, we place this last token of affection in honor of our missing comrades who have gone for their final reward. Uncover, Chaplain.
Almighty God, we praise thee, we glorify thee, and we thank thee for sparing us from the grasp of our enemies. Grant us full understandings to the suffering being endured by our comrades who are being held as prisoner of war or still missing. We ask thy blessing upon them, that whatever comforts they are denied, whatever evil they must endure, may be rebound to their everlasting happiness. Especially do we seek thy support for their loved ones. May thy grace be with them, always giving them the strength to do their daily tasks and the courage to meet the problems of life. We pray for those missing comrades who have been called to thy bosom, that whatever justice they may have been denied in this life have been granted them hundredfold. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the official part of the ceremony.
Hi, I'm Amy Williams, one of the 8th grade American history teachers here at the middle school. Every year, our students at the middle school have the opportunity to participate in an essay contest sponsored by the Veterans of Foreign War. This year's topic was What Patriotism Is to Me. Our third place winner was 6th grader Vinny Riccardi. Our second place winner was 7th grader Addie Niggett. And our first place winner was 8th grader Michael Fallert. Michael is here to share his essay with us today.
Patriotism is defined as love or devotion to our country, but it means so much more to me. Patriotism means supporting our country all of the time, whether it is a good time or a bad time. It means honoring those who have served our country, whether they are living or dead. It means always being proud to be an American. You should always support our country no matter what state it is in, whether that be good or bad. Patriotism means standing by our country and showing devotion for it no matter what. Even if America is in a rough time or struggling, you should always stand by our country and try to improve it. Patriotism also means showing support to all people, whether they are active, retired, living, or dead. They put their lives on the line to make sure our country is safe. We may not be where we are today without those brave men and women who risk their lives to secure ours. We can show our patriotism by just thinking of them and keeping them in our prayers every day. On Veterans Day, you should always thank someone who served or is currently serving. Finally, patriotism means to always be proud to be an American. There may be some times where you don't like America, but the great things always outweigh the mistakes. In America, you have a lot of freedom and privileges. Some other countries may not have things like this. We have a lot of rights given to us by the Constitution as well. We have the right to equality and freedom from discrimination, the right to life, liberty, and personal security, freedom of opinion, freedom of speech and religion, and the right to privacy. These are just a few of the great rights and freedoms we have in America. America is never perfect, but we always have to show our patriotism and stand by her and always work to improve our country to make it the best it can be.
What does being a veteran mean to you?
Serving your country.
Yeah, freedom is not free.
Wearing the uniform of your country and going wherever your country tells you to go and doing.
You get a lot of respect if you were in the military.
Well, I would argue that point. When some of us had served in the Vietnam era, when we came home, we didn't get no respect. We came home and it was a country that was in confusion. When I landed at Travis Air Force Base, they loaded us on a bus to Treasure Island, the Marines and the sailors. We were given 3 days of briefings of what the way the nation was. We were told you might as well take your uniform off and travel home in cities.
That's right.
The nation came around during Desert Storm 1, and it's been a different world for the veterans. Any man or woman that served during the Vietnam era, we missed a little bit of welcome home. A lot of people, when they see us wearing our hats or some identification that we're a veteran, they thank us, but they still don't remember what happened between 1964 and 1974.
Yep.
It was a sad time for a veteran.
food like in the service?
In Vietnam, I ate cornflakes and Kool-Aid.
SOS. SOS was very good for breakfast.
And what was SOS for the kids that don't know?
Well,
I know what it is.
Something on the shingle.
Great.
Let me know in my heart when my days are through. America, America, I gave my best to you. America,
my name is Chuck DeBellis, proudest to have served 4 years in the United States Air Force as an Airman First Class. I spent time in Korea and England, and I still don't know how I got mixed up with all these old guys.
There's always one.